for our shoes to finish. And there was so much poverty in Manila that people were living in cemetery. And Cardinal Sin said it cannot continue. The same Catholic called nuns, could come out with rosaries and sing hymns and surrounded the military headquarters to protect one military man who got angry and cannot continue with Imelda Marcos and Ferdinand Marcos. Particularly when they killed Corazon Aquino's father, it was the Cardinal Sin that led the revolution. And Imelda Marcos and the husband fled, and Corazon Aquino. In another year, in 2001, he led another revolt, replaced government again. We need men, clergymen, who can speak without being afraid. We need clergymen whose hands are clean, who have integrity, and they can now become the voice for the people, and by extension, the voice of God. I shall not talk about marriage lesson. You already know that. Let me quickly ask this very question. In Nigeria, we have our own challenges, because the challenge of a society determines the mission of the church. Number one, we have massive elite capture and kleptomania by the ruling elite. Number two, we have systematic ethnic cleansing in some parts of Nigeria now. Number three, we have gross poverty in the midst of the exploration of oil. Those who benefited from, number four, from affordable and functional educational institutions in Nigeria, have allowed them to decay, thereby depriving the next generation the right to education. Members of churches can't afford to send their children to their church schools that were built with their offerings and tithes. How can some state governors reject 30,000 naira minimum wage when some governors receive 200 million to 2 billion naira every month unaudited? The Delta State governor receives 2 billion every month. By the time you will be leaving, you have 96 billion. There are more billboards in Ugeli and Warri than the whole of Ondo State for politicians. Any nation where politicians are richer than businessmen is the den of corruption. Paul Ryan sleeps in his office in America, the Speaker of the House of Assembly. We give these rascals quarters and they jump over fence. How can a governor earn pension and then earn salary as a senator when graduates are employed? Why must the state house cleaning get more budgetary allocation than the 16 teaching hospitals join together and there's no panadol? Why must 100 million naira be spent to buy cutlery in Buhari's house and 27 million for Oshibanjo? Are the cutlery's disposable? Must you buy them every year? Somebody talk to me. How can we use 350 million to buy cooking gas? Do they use elephant for breakfast? Don't annoy me here. Why would a civil servant who has served his nation for years retire and die in a queue because he's waiting for his pension? And governors earn their money, senators earn their money. And we sit down here. How long shall they kill our prophets while we stand aside and look? God bless you.
Very much. Dr.